But yours will look, because you will be make your square paper will be accurate. Now let's start the isometric shape of it. All sides will be 4. So starting 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 1 2 3 4 children here, 1 2 3 4, or it is missing. I will make it, just wait. Here is the cube. Now if you want, you can draw the inside part also. So is your sketch unique? Will it be unique? No. Why? Because it is a cube or a cuboid with the same type of dimensions. You will get such type of, though my cube is unique, you can say, okay, because it is not looking like a cube, but yours won't be unique. Okay, so you can write, no, the sketches are not unique. So children, this completes the exercise. A little bit we are going to start with visualizing the solid objects. When we visualize the solid objects, children, you can see here. Yeah, when you see how many cubes, it's written over there, no? How many cubes? So if you are going to count the cubes, you will count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Correct? You will say there are 5 cubes. But if you see properly, okay, if you see from different angles, you will see that these 3 are there. Okay, then on the top also 3 are there. Now these top ones, are they standing on the air? No, 3 will be below also. Yes, so actually these 3 on the top, just below them 3 more. So 3 plus 3, 6, and this one 7, 8, and you can see 9 cubes. Correct. So when you look up at combined shapes, some of them may be hidden from the view. It is written over there. Okay, when sometimes when you look at combined shapes, when the shapes are combined, just now I showed you, what happens? Some of them may be hidden from the view, means we cannot see them. Okay, so depending on this, children, there is a try these, which is given in page number 286. Try to guess the number of cubes in the following arrangements. You can see the arrangements. This is the first one, the second one, and the third one. So we are going to do it now. Try these, which is given in page 286. Try to guess the number of cubes. So the first one, second one, and third one. First one is, how many are on the top? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 are on the top. So just below them, they must be having a base also. So every cube which is on the top will have a cube down also. So 12 plus 12 gives you 24. So you can write either 12 into 2, 24, or just 12. Plus 2 is, 12 plus 12 is equal to 24. Now, second one, again we will count. The first front one we are counting, 1, 2, 3. At the back is fourth, and 2 are on the top. They must be having a base down. Got it? So 5, 6, which are the top? 7, 8. So, second one is 8. Similarly, if we count the third one, 1, 2, 3, 4 are in front. Okay. And fifth one in the middle of the two tops, top views. Okay. If you say have a top cubes. Okay. So, what we can see, 1, 2, 3, 4 in the front, fifth in the middle of the two, okay, which are on the top, and which two are on the top, that is 6 and 7, and now they are not standing on the edge, so they have a base, 8 and 9, so 9 cubes. So this completes the try these. Then there is one more try these, children, which is in page 287. We are going to do it now. Two dice are placed side by side as shown. Can you say what the total would be on the face opposite to it? So we have done in our previous exercise, children, a dice. It has the numbers in such a way, if you add the opposite faces, the sum should come to be 7, right? When we were discussing the nets. So 5 plus 6. So if 5 is there in one dice, at the back of 5 will be what? 2. And 6 is there on the second dice, you can see.
Here, diagram is also given. 5 plus 6. So if 5 is here, at the back will be what? 2. Why? Because 5 plus 2 is 7.
And if in the front is 6, then at the back will be 1. Why? Because 6 plus 1 is 7. And there is B also. 4 plus 3. 4 is here. So at the back should be what? Sorry. 3. Because 4 plus 3 is 7. Now you must be thinking that this 3 is already there. This is for the second dice. Okay. This is not for the first one. It's for the second one. So 4 plus 3. And if 3 is in front, then 4 will be at the back. Okay. So this completes. Acha, there's a hint given. Remember that in a die, sum of the numbers on opposite faces is 7, which we've already done. Now question number 2. 3 cubes, each with 2 cm edge, are placed side by side to form a cuboid. Try to make an oblique sketch and say what could be the length, breadth and height. Children, we have done this. 2, 3 cubes, 2 to 2 cm. I think in the last exercise, question number 3. Okay, so from there we can write what will be the length, breadth and height. The length will be 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is 6. Cross breadth will be 2 and height will also be 2. Okay, so this completes 6 cm. Cross 2 cm, cross 2 cm. This completes this try these also. Now viewing different sections of a solid. How can you view a different section of a solid, children? How? If you take a bread, a loaf of bread. When you divide them in sections, and how we can do it? either we cut them vertically or horizontally. Okay, so this is an example. This example is given in your book also. Okay, let's take any other example. If you take a ball, if you cut like this, you will get a circular shape only, circle, circles. And if you cut like this also, horizontally also, you will get circles only. So these different pieces are known as cross sections. Okay, cross sections of a solid figure. Okay, so now we are going to start the exercise, that is exercise 15.3. Very simple exercise, children. Just one question is there. So let's do it. Why to leave it? So exercise 15.3, question number 1. Get when you give a vertical cut or a horizontal cut to the following solids. So we make a table. Solids, vertical cut, horizontal.
Continue tomorrow.